Hello, everyone. I am Laura Haverkamp. I am your instructor for SLIS 600. Today's video is our quick introduction to everything that you have to do to navigate the course in Blackboard. Little dull, but I want to make sure you know how to find things that will help you get through this semester, which is only 6 weeks, very quickly, and it'll help you hopefully answer some questions. All right. To get started in our class, of course, you'll want to open up the homepage. I've tried to keep the homepage clean and clear, so all you have on here is announcements. You can click on those to read them, or you can go over to the left toolbar over here and click on announcements, and then they will open up. And you can see so far I have two announcements up, and I will put more up as the semester goes on. I will try to keep you informed if there are any changes or any updates, or if I feel like several people need guidance on something so that I can share it with you all, I'll put that in the announcements. I don't anticipate making any changes to our schedule or to the syllabus, but anything that would change, well, I can't really change the syllabus, but anything that would change, I would post here to let you know, to give you notice. I'd also send an email to the entire class, so it'll show up in both announcements and an email if I need to change anything or update something. So that's the homepage and the announcements. Okay, so now I have clicked over to course documents. In the course documents, you'll see that we have the syllabus, course schedule, stories, and storytelling links and resources. If I scroll down here, there's also USC resources, which should be pretty standard, tech and tech support, and citations. I take APA citations, by the way. All right, so I'm going to click over on, you would click on the syllabus and it would take you to a Google Doc, which has the syllabus on it. This is a fairly standard syllabus for USC. The only thing that might be particularly different, I mean, you should always read the syllabus, but the only thing that's going to inform you in a different way than other courses would be the assignment weights, points, how I grade. So you will have four storytelling assignments. Those are worth 40 points. You will have blogs. Those are worth 18 points, and those will be cumulative. So when you post your first blog, you'll get 3 points, et cetera. You get it. There is a digital storytelling assignment, which is like your fifth assignment for storytelling, but I've separated that out. There is a reflective essay at the end, which is really only a page. Relax. And I will grade you. You will earn points on class participation, commenting on other people, your video intro, all that good stuff. All that's going to earn you points along the way for a total possible points of 100. I've tried to make this as simple and straightforward as possible. I've also tried to make it reflect the level of effort that each thing takes. And so the storytelling assignments are clearly the weighted more heavily than the others. All right, so that all that's in the syllabus. Let's go back to content. The next thing you're going to want to look at is the course schedule. This is your Bible for the class. I'm going to go ahead and click on the course schedule. We're going to look at the first week together here during this video. So the class schedule for this summer, classes begin on Monday, May 11th. We will do our class introduction. When you look at the schedule, it tells you what week it is, the topic, and the content you will need to cover, and any assignments that are due during the week. I have tried to make the assignments very regular throughout the semester. So you will have something due on Tuesday and Friday. And then Tuesday and Friday, except for the last week where you have three things due, I can give you a little flex on that last day. I'm going to count. There isn't a final, but your final paper can count as a final, just to give us a little bit more leeway if you get bogged down in that last week. We'll address that later. Okay, so in week one, we have three topics: class introduction and the background and history of storytelling, storytelling preparation and selection, and performance technique and style. You will see in that center that, or on the left, it says week one over here, week one, week one, week one. So you know you have three things in week one. That means this is a busy week. All right, it tells you our topics in the next square, and then things you need to do and due dates and your readings that go along with this. right? So keep in mind, in this first week, you're going to be looking for fables, fairy tales, and folk tales. You are going to be turning in your video introduction. You are going to be turning in your first blog. You're going to be reading chapters 1 through 6 in our textbook, our lovely, lovely storytelling art and technique. I hope you have ordered that. It is really, I promise, it's an excellent book. All right, so make sure you save this schedule, maybe print it out, refer to it often so you don't lose track of time, and this course schedule should keep you on track. All right, I've clicked back over in course documents, just so you know where I am in Blackboard, and then I'm going to click on stories under course documents and open that up. As we look at what's available on this page, I want to point out a couple of things. First, story types. Story types is going to help you if you're unsure on the definition I'm using. I've tried to provide that for you. So story types here is providing you with definitions for this class. If you've taken any kind of philosophy class or even advanced librarianship class, there's lots of arguing over definitions. So let's make a deal between us that a fable or a fairy tale is what I've said it is. We can argue lots of other things. And obviously some fables fit as fairy tales and vice versa, or a folk tale can be a legend. There's crossover. If you can make a good argument that it fits in a category, I will be fine with that. Anyway, so here you go. Here are the types of stories. I'm going to go back over to that content. I'm in the stories in our course documents. So we looked at story types. I want to let you know the International Children's Digital Library and EPIC are great online resources for stories. I'm making a point of pointing those out right now because a lot of us are trapped in our houses. We don't have access to the public library. We don't have access to our own school libraries if you're already working in a school. So those online resources should get you started as far as finding books, fables, fairy tales to use for this class. You might have to print some stuff out to help you memorize things as the course goes on. I'm also hoping that since you're in a library school class and a storytelling class, that you live in a print-rich environment. But I do realize that not everybody lives in a print-rich environment that is like mine. I have all my children's books from when my kids were young. I have fable and fairy tale books all over the place. I have books that were gifted to me from my parents and from older colleagues when my children were young. So I have a whole series of fable and fairy tale folk legend books. So corral your resources, and those two online resources can help you do that. I wanted to make sure you knew those were there. I'm here in the course documents again, looking at the list of things. We just looked at stories. There's lots of good stuff in there. Make sure you use it. And I have this link here called Storytelling Links and Resources. It's a bit of overkill. There's more information there than you will ever have a chance to use during this class, since it's only 6 weeks. But I wanted to offer you a resource where storytelling links, information, access, is all in one place. So you might browse a couple of them, but that document is a bit of overkill. It's got so much stuff in it, it overwhelms me. Okay. Also in our course documents, a link to USC resources, technology and tech support, and of course, a link to citations. I would suggest if you are unfamiliar with doing citations, get familiar. There's not a lot of opportunity for you to do citations in here, but if you're going to quote something, make sure you do a citation, please. And I prefer APA format. Okay. All right. Next up on our course list over here is weekly content. You might not be seeing this yet, but as soon as I get this video up, you should be able to see at least the first video. When you click on weekly content, it is going to look like this. Week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, week 5, 6, 5 and 6. Okay. So the weeks are divided out, and the things that you need for the most part are stuck in these folders. So I'm going to go ahead and click on week one content. It has readings and videos. You will find two or three contents, like ideas or two or three sections as you go through each weekly content. So class introduction is our first topic. You will find the lectures posted under lecture. Please watch those lectures first. You need to watch the lectures. If I'm going to bother to sit here and talk at this machine, please, you know, take the time to watch the lectures. All right. So my lectures should max out at about 20 minutes because I get sick of talking and you'll be sick of hearing me. I get it. But there's also good content in the lectures. The lectures are going to cover the book, but the book is more in depth and richer than my lectures. So I try to make sure I provide the lectures for you because people have different learning modalities. And we all know that you need to hear something more than once in order to cement it in your brain. So if you've read it and then you hear it from me, hopefully that'll help you with the learning process. Okay. So each week, make sure you watch your lectures. It's pretty passive. Just, you know, do that. Then you will find posted readings. So you will have the first three chapters of the book and a reading. And then for topic two, there's a little outline here about what topic two is and what you're supposed to be learning. And there will be a lecture, an article, the next topic. Okay, so hopefully this is clear to you. You will have two or three topics a week. You will have a lecture, you will have a reading or a few readings. Now, I recognize that many of us are working full-time while taking this class. And so here's my recommendation. As you take the class, watch the lectures, read the book, read the articles. If you are maxed out and can't read the articles, please open the articles and read the abstracts. If the article is a page or two, please try and choke it down, okay? Nothing in this class is a gotcha. There is nothing in this class where I'm trying to catch you. So it's up to you to make the most of it. Just keep that in mind. Okay. All right, I've been talking too long. We need to be faster. So next up is assignments. It's over on the left. I've clicked on assignments. There's an assignment that tells you how to do your individual blogs. There's an assignment that tells you how to do your storytelling experiences. There's a digital storytelling assignment sheet and the reflective paper assignment sheet. These are all fairly self-explanatory. If you open them up and read your instructions, you will do fine. For discussions, this is where you're going to post your storytelling experiences. So when you do your stories, you're going to post in the discussions. There is a student forum, so if you have a question, you can post in the student forum and one of us, like hopefully, you know, your classmates or I will answer. I will try to check that on a daily basis. I will check it on a daily basis. Your first discussion assignment is the Getting to Know Me that is on your course schedule. You're going to create a very short video and introduce yourself to the class. The instructions are right here in Getting to Know Me. That is due Tuesday the 12th. All right, your storytelling presentations will be posted here. You will have you are obliged to also comment on other people's work. You're going to comment on three classmates. So you will be earning a grade for your storytelling presentation, but your comments to other classmates will also be included in your class participation grade. So make sure you're commenting on other people's work. Please do not trash your classmates. People are going to come into this class with a wide variety of skills. I'm looking for improvement. There will be some people who will be excellent from the get-go. There are some people who will be rough around the edges. So my request to you is please be kind. Please be kind to your classmates. Not everybody is a brilliant storyteller, but we want people to appreciate storytelling and get better as the semester goes on. All right, y'all. We also have blogs in this class, but they're not really blogs. It's more a way of, I'm using blogs sort of like a discussion board or where you can post reaction papers. The assignments link tells you how to do your blog. You have six different blogs to do. You will be reacting to things in the course. You have to write at least three paragraphs, and then you have to respond to a couple of your classmates again. So the blog is a place for you to sort of react to what you're learning in the class as we go along. We also have one spot over here on the left, assignment submission. I'll click on that. This is for your final reflective paper. Your final reflective paper is just a short reaction to the course, kind of like a five-paragraph essay, one page, two page, should be fine. Also down here, we have instructor. Here is my little bio, but I will also post a video bio in our discussion board where you have to post a video bio, all right? So there's me looking better rested and slightly younger. And there's my bio and my contact info. All right, so I'm hoping that by looking at this, you can find what you need to find. You have blogs to do, discussions, which are mostly just posting your storytelling. We have a reflective paper at the end. You have two assignments a week, except for the last week where you have three. I should be available by email pretty quickly. I try to respond quickly. I know librarians tend to be very sensitive and they tend to be worried about doing things correctly. It's hard to mess up in here unless you just don't do the work. So if you're having any trouble, please let me know. And I hope this has helped you figure out where things are in the course. If you feel like something is not intuitive or something doesn't work, please let me know ASAP. All right, storytellers, I look forward to hearing your first stories. And good luck, y'all.